rock a ball, baby. Rock a ball, baby.
Hi, my name is Nikhil from UDOT. So I started dancing when I was 17 years old. So that's mean I've been dancing for 11 years now. And mainly hip hop. My best dance memory. I don't really have one best memory, but I do have, you know, a lot since I've been dancing. What I really appreciate most of the time is when people get inspired from what I do, it's always a good feeling, because I'm thinking, okay, even though I'm not rich or something like this, but at least I can, you know, kind of inspire people. So I started dancing just because for me it was fun, it was cool. I can also, you know, pick up some girls like this when I was younger, so it was a good thing to do. My earliest memory is, you know, when you're dancing at the beginning, you're doing a lot of stuff, but you think that you're good, and then once you start, you know, watching people who are much, like, way better than you, and then I remember this the effect that had on me. It was with actually my cool Yuda. I was dancing for what, 2 years, and we went to a battle, and I saw this guy dancing. I was like, wow, they must have been dancing for at least 10 years. And then I went to them and I asked them, you know, how long have you been dancing? They said 2 years. And it was exactly the same thing as me, 2 years. But their level compared to mine was like ridiculous. Before, when I was like 20, I was definitely like a bachelor, because I wanted to prove, you know, to the freestyle community that I could do something. And in our crew, UDOT, we were all like this, you know. We don't care if you are, you know, older than us, if you have more experience. I used to have this mentality, but now I don't think I've got this fire anymore. I do some battles sometimes, you know. I do battles sometimes, you know, just to enjoy, you know, just to get this feeling back, you know. But I see myself more as an artist. What do I think about London hip hop scene compared to Paris, Amsterdam, or other places? UK has a lot of potential. I've met some great, you know, choreographers here, dancers here. But what I found very unfortunate is, I feel like UK in London, you need to be there to know what's going on. So the world doesn't know what's going on in UK. The world doesn't know what's going on in London. This is what I found very unfortunate, because when there is something happening in Paris, the world knows about it, you know, because it's on YouTube. They use social media the proper way to, you know, to show, you know, what's going on in Paris. In Amsterdam, the same thing. My greatest feeling was seeing Josh, a young, very, very motivated and talented kid, beating everyone. So that was a good thing to see, because, you know, I mean, to me, this is how I see it. If we have young people like this who's training hard to get better, that's mean our culture will never die. I want to contribute to the growth of this dance community. I believe today, you know, with the technology, we can expand the revenue stream of dancers, you know, because at the moment, the only way we can make money is we always use the same method, which is, you know, teaching, workshops, traveling, performing, but there is more we can do. So this is why I started a company about a year ago now, called dance.com, dance.com. So it's dance with three C's. And the whole idea is to help dancers, you know, to grow and earn, you know, from their creativity without being there physically. This is Nikhil, representing UDOT, UDOT crew from Paris. Yeah, so guys, just one thing I wanted to tell you before leaving. I will be there and try and prove this year again, just to, you know, to chill, to dance, and that's it. So big up to Trump House. That was a Trump House session.